A very pleasant good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome once again to the People's Forum of In the Streets with Big Stone. About 2 years ago, I did a video about a young man. His name is Miguel Williams. Now, as you know, Miguel was wrongly accused of raping a little girl by the name of Shante Skyers. And as a result of those accusations, Miguel Williams was wrongfully chopped and burned to death. I spoke with his mother, Charmaine, and I could see in her eyes the pain of losing someone. Now, I've spoken to many mothers who have lost a child, but to lose a child innocently in terms of being accused of a terrible action, and then jungle justice was brought to play. So I understand the feeling of a mother who went through that. And I sat down and I spoke to her. You can go on my channel, Big Stone Television, and take a look at the video. Now, there's another situation like that happened recently in St. Thomas. And I read to the Loop newspaper. It says, angry mob kills man mistaken for St. Thomas abductor. An angry mob on Wednesday morning killed a man who was mistakenly identified as a suspect in the recent abduction of two girls in Bath, St. Thomas. The incident happened in Landouille, St. Thomas, at about 8 o'clock in the morning. Senior Superintendent of Police Stephanie Lindsay, head of the Force Corporate Communication Unit, CCU, confirmed the mob killing incident. The man was killed by a mob in St. Thomas. After 8 o'clock this morning, detectives were still on the ground and they have discovered that the man who was killed is not Davian Bryan, Lindsay said. According to police reports, the now deceased man was seen walking along the Landouille main road and was approached by a resident armed with machetes. He reportedly ran into bushes and across the Yalas River, but was chased by the mob, with person eventually inflicting several wounds to his body. He was subsequently taken to hospital by the police, but was pronounced dead at the facility. Now, ladies and gentlemen, that is painful. Painful because a young man, especially one also suffering from unsound mind, was brutally murdered. Because that is murder. And oftentimes you hear me speak about jungle justice. Oftentimes you hear me talk about we taking the law into our own hands. Jamaica, we need to stop doing this. We need to stop doing this. But like I said in prior videos, I do understand the frustration on the citizens of this country. What has been going on in terms of 1,140 people being killed since the beginning of this year, 2021. A lot of children are killed, kidnapped. We don't even know where they are. A lot of strange happenings, especially what is happening or unfolded in Montego Bay. So our citizens have had it up to their neck. But at the same time, we cannot add to our frustration the killing of an innocent person. In America, they have a creed of law that says it's best for 100 guilty people go free than for them to execute one innocent person. Jamaica, it is rough now on the families of this man, this poor man who I heard just wash cars for a living. A poor man who had nothing more to do than just run when he saw an angry mob, knowing very well he could not have explained himself. Jamaica, stop it. Stop it, Jamaica. It is wrong and it has caused a lot of pain. Now, we understand the frustration. Yes, two children kidnapped in less than 48 hours apart by the same person, as per the police report. But at the same time, both of these children was returned home with their lives. I could understand the frustration as if we'd lost any of those children to this maniac, but both children were returned home to their families. Why did we have to kill? Why? Even if that was Davion Bryan, why would we want to kill him? See, in the United States of America, when they arrest a suspect involved in an hideous crime, they don't want to kill him. They want to hold on to him to find out first his state of mind. Second, is he acting alone? Third, is this part of a conspiracy to kill more children or abduct more children? How many people are involved? Who's financing it? And all that. But when you kill him on the spot, you kill all that information. So if we had other children hostage somewhere else, or this is part of a ring, or this is something that is a plot, then we lose the opportunity to get those information. Jamaica, I know you're frustrated. I am frustrated. All of us are frustrated about what is happening, the high crime rate and so on. I understand that. But let me tell you something. When you look into the eyes of a mother who lost a loved one, and especially one that is not guilty of a crime, and it's up to you to give of your heart to that mother like I did. Our children are very important. Our children in this beautiful country are very important, and they mean a lot to us. We cannot afford to lose our children. But at the same time, we cannot afford to lose our citizens innocently. That's all for now. Please like, share, and if you have not yet subscribed to my channel, now is the time for you to do so. Thank you so much.